The universe is unimaginably vast, with hundreds of billions of galaxies, each containing hundreds of billions of stars. In our galaxy alone, the Milky Way, there could be tens of billions of habitable planets. So, where is everybody? Given the potential for intelligent life to evolve on other worlds, why have we found no evidence for the existence of extraterrestrial civilizations? This puzzle is known as the Fermi paradox. The size and age of our universe suggests that intelligent life should be common. Even if the odds of intelligent life developing on a habitable planet were exceedingly rare, with so many planets distributed across billions of galaxies, you'd expect intelligent, technologically advanced aliens to exist. Italian physicist Enrico Fermi recognized this apparent contradiction between the lack of evidence and high probability estimates back in 1950, famously asking over lunch, "Where is everybody?" His question became known as the Fermi paradox. Here are the main solutions proposed to resolve this mystery. First, we haven't searched enough for the universe yet. Space is inconceivably vast. We've only listened for signals from a tiny fraction, less than a billion trillionth, of the galaxy. And we have no idea how common life is or at what point it becomes detectable. It may require searching thousands or millions of star systems before finding a civilization advanced enough to be noticed. Second, advanced civilizations may only transmit signals for a relatively brief period of time before going silent. Humanity's loud radio broadcasts have only been transmitting for about a century. A civilization broadcasting for a similar window would be unlikely to line up with the tiny sliver of time we've been listening. Third, we may not be listening for the right signals. Alien civilizations could be using communication technology that human scientists have not yet discovered. There are likely forms of communication we can't detect. We're like a remote tribe in the Amazon rainforest searching for aircraft with our naked eyes. Fourth, space is a dangerous place. Advanced civilizations tend to destroy themselves once they reach a critical level of technological capability. They may obliterate their habitats through nuclear war, biological terrorism, climate change, or an accidental physics experiment gone wrong. Self-destruction may be the inevitable fate of technological cultures. Fifth, intelligent life may choose not to reveal itself. To avoid cultural contamination, drawing attention from hostile alien species, or being infringed by curious neighbors, some civilization may exercise discretion, deliberately masking their presence. The galaxy could be teeming with hidden aliens. Sixth, a single dominant civilization may exist that destroys expanding cultures as it encounters them. Like human empires that conquered the globe and destroyed societies in their path, an imperial civilization may have colonized the galaxy, snuffing out alien life and preventing interstellar communication. And finally, the frightening possibility that humankind is the first and only civilization to have reached an advanced stage. We may be alone in our galaxy, and perhaps even the visible universe, condemned to wander a lifeless void for all eternity. The Fermi paradox continues to mystify scientists, but our search for alien signals has only just begun. As we further explore our galaxy, the cosmos beyond, and listen for messages we never dreamed of, perhaps we may someday find ourselves no longer alone.